horror. Now, however you look on horror, there is one thing that pretty much everybody can agree on. It's that horror is scary. Or at least horror is meant to be scary. We'll get on that later. But what is scary, exactly? Scary is the feeling of feeling my phone start falling down while I'm recording a video. I'm joking, by the way. But scary. Now, let's see if I can pop up here. Yeah, that'll do. But I think there's about at least 5 types of scary. At least that. I don't know. I'm gonna just name them off. But the first type is spooky. Spooky is children scary. Spooky is something that could startle your toddler if you put it in front of them. Technically, just like Frankenstein, mummies, that stuff. That is spooky. Just like classic Halloween stuff that can, like, I'm gonna use something. Take the Halloween ghost from Spirit Halloween 2023 this year. Would that really scare any adults, to be honest? Not really. Would that probably, like, scare a 3-year-old? Yes. But again, if you take your 3-year-old to Spirit Halloween, you might have thought that'd be nice, but again, these exist. But that's spooky. First type. Second type. I'm recording in my closet. My sister's watching Unspeakable right now. The second type of horror is scary. What is scary? Let's take. You see a zombie heading, running towards you at super fast speeds. That is scary. That's the one time, it's taking like flight or fight. Flight, fight, fight, flight. My dog is moaning in the other room. Anyways, it's taking like that. Do you freeze? Do you fight it? Or do you start running for your life? That's scary. You know it's there and you know you have to start running for your life. That's scary. It's technically like, let's take Ghostface. I'll put a picture up for the people that don't know who he is. You should though. Technically, if you have just seen Ghostface outside, that's scary. Because now you know, well, I'm about to die. But that's scary. It's technically just knowing it's there. But what? Not knowing it's there. You can call it either 2 different types. There's uneasy and unknown. What does that mean? Uneasy and unknown are technically the fear of the unknown. Technically, did you see those shimmers on my eyes? Yeah, my glasses. That scared me. But that is unknown scariness or uneasiness. That is technically just the fear of the unknown. Your body just starts freaking out like, something here. And technically it just puts it into another flight or fight response. Technically just making you go, nope. I'm out. Again, that is the fear of the unknown. Technically, just feeling uneasy about the situation you're in. Okay? Now I'm gonna switch over to the video essay mode for a second. Okay. Anyways, my nose is bugging me. Anyways, the fourth type of scary is horror. What's horror? Horror can be classified as like horror movies. Like watching something scary to go down. Like say you're out with your buddy in the morning and I drive out. And then while doing that, your friend gets robbed. Like full on kidnapped and taken away. He gets robbed. But you're left. Now, say another guy comes back. that's horror. It's technically just the more extreme, just scary. That's horror. It's technically know that it's not even scary. It's not the scary type where you know, oh my god, I'm so scared I might die today. No, horror is, well, that's gone, I'm dying today. It's 100% without a doubt, you're gonna die. Like, you know you're gonna die, and you know how it's gonna happen, and you know that you're screwed, you're dead, you're gone. That's horror. Now, what's the last type? The last type is uncanny. If you don't know what uncanny means, it's technically like, take back to one of those old movies that you watched as a child, like Alvin and the Chipmunks, Hop, the live action but CGI movies. Yeah, those movies can be put into the uncanny valley, which technically means take a baby doll. Now, there's a cartoony baby doll that's really cute. That's just normal. Now let's add a bit more realism to that, okay? Wow, ant. Okay, bit not let that cute now, though. Now let's say you try your absolute best to make it look like a human. That's uncanny valley. The point where it's too human. It looks like it's trying to mimic a human. That's the uncanny valley, where something just seems off. Like your brain is trying to figure out, is this a threat? Is this threatening your life? Do you need to worry? And most of the times, our brains kick in like, I'm out. Whoop. But that's the uncanny part, where something is not in danger, is not opposed to the danger to you, but your brain still thinks it is. Now, I'm gonna switch over to the other side of horror. This one was just documenting what horror was in the first place. I don't know why I spent like, oh my god, 8 minutes talking about this. I should probably put like a timer saying skip ahead to this part to actually hear my opinions on it. Oh my god, bro. Do I like horror? Simple answer, yes. Long answer, the rest of the video. Okay, get off if you want to hear me rant for another couple of minutes. You here? Okay. Now, let's begin. Okay, now my sister's watching Mr. Beast, I guess.
Okay, guys, it's currently the other day because I had to go get school stuff. So, yeah. Also, my screen is like bugging out while I'm watching this. Oh, it's got better. A little bit better, I don't know. Oh, no, it's just glitching. Anyways, what's my own opinion on horror? My own physical opinion on horror is that I love horror. Look in my room and you see it. I just don't want to show you my room. I'm not doxing myself. I have a whole bunch of stuff over there that's just dedicated to horror because I love it. I've watched over 200 horror movies now. Most of them were absolutely doo-doo, but a lot of them were great. Also, what's your favorite horror movie franchise? There's Friday the 13th, there's the Firefly trilogy, then there's Friday the 13th, then there's the Nightmare on Elm Street, there's Child's Play, not Chuck, you idiot. Yeah, there's just a couple of ones. There's the It franchise. I'm gonna say it. I love the Halloween franchise. It's probably my favorite horror movie franchise. Nightmare on Elm Street is a close second. Now, what am I going to do? Before I said that I would make a Halloween ranking video, I never made that. Might as well just do it now. So skip to this if you do not want to see this happen. Okay, I think there's like 13 or something. Worst horror movie, Halloween Resurrection. Second worst, Halloween 2, Rob Zombie's one. I hate some of the stuff that Rob Zombie has made is just too goofy and weird for me. I could barely even watch House of a Thousand Corpses, bro. But after that, I'm gonna say it. I gotta go with Halloween 5. After that, I have to go with Halloween 6. I kinda like Halloween 6 because of the gore. Because, you know, if Michael gets his hands on you, you're gone. You're gone, bro. You're screwed. You're about to meet an untimely fate. But after that, I got to give it to... What's one of the worst? What's a really bad one? Okay, I have no other place to put this. I gotta go for Rob Zombie's Halloween 1. After that, I got to probably give it to Halloween Kills. After that, I have to give it to Halloween 3. After that, I gotta give it to Halloween 2. Then after that, I have to give it to Halloween 4. Then Halloween H2O. Then Halloween Ends. Then the 2018 Halloween. And then the original. You can get all mad at me for saying that Halloween Ends is good, but I don't care. I liked that movie. I do not care that Michael was only in it for like 5 minutes. I don't care. If I can see somebody killing them looks like Michael, that's good enough, bro. Enjoying a slasher here. Just enjoy the movie. Think of this not as a Halloween movie. And boom, you're good. And my defense for putting Halloween Resurrection as the worst is that I have no defense. Only smart people should be able to come to that understanding. Halloween 2 was horrible too. The Rob Zombie one. Horrible. Horrible. I don't know what they did. They gave Rob Zombie full creative control and he said, let me ruin a franchise. Yeah. Okay. Now back onto my opinions. Why do I love Halloween? I love Halloween because of Michael. I love Halloween because of the story. Because everything, you have to put it together on yourself. You have to make sure that, oh, so this didn't happen in the timelines, so this happened, and that. It gives it some fun thing with also see Michael's slash bodies. And I just love Michael's appearance. His voidless eyes, unlike Halloween H2O, that it just is so creepy and cool. That if I ever saw this dude walking towards me, I'm pretty sure I'd just have a heart attack and die right there. Anyways. What's my even favorite horror movie? What's my favorite horror movie, you might be asking. And number three, I gotta give it to the original Halloween. I have to give it to the original Nightmare on Elm Street. I loved that movie. For number two, I gotta give it to the original Halloween. And number one, I gotta give it to the Silence of the Lambs. I don't know if you can count Silence of the Lambs as a horror movie. It's more of a thriller. But that Silence of the Lambs is just so good, bro. I'm not joking. Okay. Move on. Only have a short time to record this since I'm going to a cold spring soon, so. Anyways, should you watch horror? Personally, I think if you're ready for it, only watch horror if you think you can do it. Only if you watch a single horror movie and you say, "Nope, I'm never watching horror again," I don't care. No one cares. Your family doesn't care. Your mom doesn't care. Your dog doesn't even care. You're worthless. Your opinion is at least. But it's your opinion. So who cares what other people think? So only watch horror if you want to. Okay. I have to edit this video. So, last.